Whether we live in Islamophobic societies in the West or in Eastern societies, where there is another kind of phobia, the phobia of strong, empowered women. I'm sure that at some point in our lives, we've been faced with that uncomfortable question. Do I blend in or do I take a stand? Blending in seems quick and easy, but it often strips us of our authenticity, our identity, and our beliefs. Standing up for our faith and practice is difficult and socially awkward, but it is a major part of the legacy of Sayyida Fatima salamullah alayha. Her birth, her upbringing, and her sermon challenged the unjust stereotyping of women. In a society that took pride in burying their daughters alive, her birth was not just welcomed, but celebrated. While most fathers looked upon their daughters as liability, her father, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, loved her as his mother, calling her Abiha, and cherished her as a partner, referring to her as Bab'atum Minni. In a culture that thought family name and lineage could continue only through a male child, the Prophet announced that his bloodline would continue in the children of Fatima Zahra sallallahu alaihi. This was an alarmingly radical statement against the culture of his time. Fatima Zahra salamullah alayha's sermon also shocked the society and culture. By protesting the confiscation of her lands in Fedak, she demolished the false stereotype that a pious muhajjib woman should not engage in socio-political activism and absolutely should not publicly address a male-dominated audience in a mosque. She reminded Muslims that each one of us has a duty to uphold the truth, and that the face of activism must be seen, and that the voice of justice must be heard, even if that upsets the status quo. She could have used the door that connected her house to the mosque, but she chose to take the route from the street into the main mosque entrance. You might think that she was able to do that because she was Fatima, Sayyidatun Nisa al-Alameen, the daughter of a revolutionary man like the Prophet, and the wife of a supportive husband like Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. I like to think of her as someone who inspired others through her brave choices and not just because of her lofty connections. As I make this comparison between the society then and the society now, it saddens me to note that even within the communities of the lovers of the Ahlul Bayt, there exists a form of violence against women, which we do not like to raise, pretending that it will disappear on its own. I am referring to domestic violence against women and sometimes children. I wonder how husbands don their black clothes during Fatimiyya and weep over the broken ribs of Zahra salamullah alayha, and then themselves physically abuse the women in their care. And most of the time, the victimized women suffer in denial because our society does not want to get involved and take a stand. So this Fatimiyya, as you attend lectures on Sayyida Fatima's life and her sermon, ask yourself that question again. Do I blend in or do I take a stand? If you choose to take a stand for faith and justice, then know that it will still be the more difficult and socially awkward option. But it will be the right option, the Fatimi option.